What's going on, guys? Jake here with Venter Visuals, and today I am stoked to be showing you guys how to create this super dope freeze frame zoom through effect. In this video, we're gonna be breaking down some simple concepts and combining them to get an overall advanced looking transition. We'll be starting in Premiere Pro, where I've cut out a section of a music video edit that I'm working on for an artist named Steezy. We're gonna take a look at some of these clips and determine where we want this effect to start.
Aesthetic, yeah, we let them have it,
Got a heavy synth beat, a lot of hard-hitting drums in the background. I'm thinking right after this kind of subtle zoom in here, we'll go ahead and make a cut right there on that clip, and we're gonna drag it to video layer 2. Drag our next clip out underneath it, highlight both those clips, right-click, and hit replace with After Effects composition. What I'm gonna do with our top layer is right-click on it, come up to time, hit freeze frame. This is gonna freeze our layer here. Hit Command D on this layer twice, so 1, 2. So let's call our top layer head, and then we'll rename the second one to body. We'll rename this third one to background. With our head layer selected, take my pen tool, start tracing out the head, come down to my mask, feather the mask just a little bit. Select our body layer now, come up to our pen tool, and we're gonna start tracing out the body. Come up to my pan behind anchor point tool up here at the top, and I'm just gonna move the anchor point, and I'm gonna put it right in the middle of our tracing there. And then I'm gonna do the same thing with the body layer. I'm gonna shift click on both the head and body layers. We're gonna open up the position keyframes, make a quick position keyframe there at the beginning, come about 8 frames to the end. Let's move these individually. Let's move the head a little bit up this way, move the body a little bit this way. At the end, we're gonna have them both falling out of the frame so they are not visible anymore. And you can see as I move them, they create the keyframes automatically. I really like to use this tool called Flow for keyframes. You can get this plugin on aescripts.com. Go with the standard ease out. You can tweak this right in the plugin. I think what we'll do is decrease the influence of this curve a little bit more so it slows down a little bit more. And we can also drag these ending keyframes out maybe a few more frames here. So let's just drag our layers out. So make sure you have motion blur turned on as you're animating your layers. Highlight both of the head and the body, click R on our keyboard. We're gonna select rotation. So let's rotate these layers around until we're a little bit more than like an entire 360. And then we'll move those keyframes here to the very end. Let's highlight my keyframes. I'm gonna tweak the graph just a little bit here and make it a little bit slower. Yeah, so this is looking pretty good already. The next step is gonna be selecting your background layer, coming up to your pen tool, trace out, kind of walk it around the edges here, open up our background layer, come down to masks, and then select this box for inverted. Let's go ahead and feather the edges a little bit here. I can turn our next clip layer on underneath this layer. So you can start to see the next clip showing through this mask we just made. We're going to select our background layer, drop down our transform properties. We're going to make a keyframe for position and scale. Let's move that 4 frames in. And then let's zoom in the rest of the frame. So right there, let's start to zoom in this mask as it flies through. Boom, it reveals the next clip. Easy ease our keyframes here. We're going to turn motion blur on for this layer. Let's turn our head and body layers back on here in the beginning. I'm actually going to stagger the rotation values for the head and the body a little bit so that they rotate at slightly different speed. Highlight all my layers, right click on them, and hit pre-compose, come up here to window, come down to extensions, and we're gonna open up shake sauce. Select one of these keyframed flashes here. As you can see, we can get a nice preview of what each one is gonna look like. So let's click on this hard hit with flash, just save this back into Premiere Pro.
We like the static, yeah, we let them have it, yeah, we up like
If you're interested in getting a free editing pack, make sure to check out my video editing shop link down below. Until next time, I'm Jake Venter. Peace out.